illustrated an aerial 3D display, which can project text and images in the air.
Hello, I'm Richard D. Hall, and I would like to show you some compelling new information about the September the 11th attacks on the World Trade Center.
As well as prioritizing transportability.
Planes were not passing birds. Planes were very small. In some cases, there was no plane at all.
Technology.
Tonight, with tensions high between the U.S. and China, an inside look at China's fleet of high-altitude balloons.
What a nice boat. Do you want it back?
In the South China Sea.
We found the launch site. It's marked with a big sign saying military zone. U.S. officials say they know this is where the Chinese balloon took off and made its way across the Pacific.
The U.S. believes a fleet of Chinese airships and balloons has flown over dozens of countries.
Anyway.
Dozens of countries conducting surveillance from near space.
Here we go.
China says the U.S. shot down a weather balloon. Officials here accused the U.S. of flying spy balloons in Chinese airspace.
Blew the whole circus away.
Can you smell the circus, Georgie?
There's all these noises, I think, I don't know.
We were there on the day that will live in infamy. Inside Edition's never to be forgotten.
Is there any idea how this happened?
But the only thing that's different about it is that it's iron blocking built.
What, if any kind of an aircraft is inside the building, this is the best vantage point right here, and as you can see, just a huge gaping hole throughout the entire side of this tower. But no doubt a lot of activity on the ground right now. telling us to back off.
This is an official civil defense film produced. Produced in cooperation with the Federal Civil Defense Administration and in consultation with the Safety Commission of the National Education Association.
These factors made me suspect it was perhaps a different object to what was seen in the other clips. Using Building 7 as a guide, I set about working out an
finish it.
Every day, the news brings more and more images of random violence, torture, and sexual aggression right into our living rooms. Violence and violent images permeate more and more aspects of our lives. And I think it's time to draw the line. I know that one place parents want us to draw the line is with violence in video games. The fact
because the shot was aired live, after they realized the errors in their production, they frantically fade the footage to black, but are too late to conceal their tricks. This is just one of many anomalies exposed in Simon Shack's film for the second impact. Note that no plane is seen in any of NBC's live images. In this lower quality VCR recorded version, the camera does not switch, so we can see the resulting explosion. If we consider the path of the ball, it appears to be what causes the impact.
What is that?
It's a
gun.
Once again, get ready.
What
is that word? Sound it out. What word? Start from the
beginning. For the second impact. Note that no plane is seen.
Decepticon!
Inserted in the narrow shot. Also, there was evidence that a layer mask had been used, behind which the editors had tried to make the plane disappear. However, the position of the layer mask, which was intended to be the hanging tower, drifts to the left due to the camera drift, which reveals the damning evidence of their video faking. Finally, because the shot was aired live, after they realized the errors in their production, they frantically fade the footage to black. Are too late to conceal their tricks. This is just one of many anomalies exposed. The footage on the left is the live image, and on the right is the evening news image. Sequences are synchronized in slow motion. The images at first sight seem as though they are from totally different camera views, but in fact, they are not. By comparing the perspective of the tower, we can see that these two images are probably filmed by the same camera, and certainly in the same position. They have in fact modified three aspects of the recorded live images to create them. I set about proving myself wrong. It's the damning evidence of their video fakery. Finally, because this shot was aired live, after they realized...
World Trade Center.
Really excited to be here.
It's the same thing.
What is that?
The fast way. Get ready.
Plane.
Yes, plane. Get ready.
Must.
Yes, must. Let's read these words the fast way without making a mistake. Get ready.
Kite.
Yes.
Most of the errors in their production, they frantically fade the footage to black, but are too late to conceal their tricks. This is just one of many anomalies exposed in Simon Shack's film.
of our SRA reading program. Direct instruction.
I know very well where that came from.
Errors in their production, they frantically fade the footage to black, but are too late to conceal their tricks. This is just one of many anomalies. news channel, allegedly filmed from a helicopter. NBC were also broadcasting live. In their live footage, seconds before the strike on World Trade Center 2, what has been described as a ball comes into the shot on a seemingly straight path.
There he is. This guy's a legend. Like the chairman of the board. Yo, freshman, point the gun.
That was the end of a 14-pound metallic sphere that had killed two scientists not 11 months before.
Note that no plane is seen in any of NBC's live images. In this lower quality VCR recorded version, the camera does not switch so we can see the resulting explosion. If we consider the path of the ball, it appears to be what causes the impact on World Trade Center 2. Both its trajectory and its speed.
World Trade Center?
That's the same thing.
What is that?
It's a good.
Our way of life, our very freedom came under attack. A series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts. The victims were in airplanes or in their offices. Secretaries, businessmen and women, military and federal workers, moms and dads, friends and neighbors. Thousands of lives were suddenly ended by evil.
Thank you.
flying into buildings, fires burning, huge structures collapsing, have filled us with disbelief, terrible sadness, and a quiet, unyielding anger. These acts of mass murder were intended to frighten our nation into chaos and retreat. But they have failed. Our country is strong. A great people has been moved to defend a great nation. Terrorist attacks can shake the foundations of our biggest buildings, but they cannot touch the foundation of America. These acts shatter steel. Strangers and neighbors who came to give blood and help in any way they could. Immediately following the first attack, I implemented our government's emergency response plans. Our military is powerful and it's prepared. Our emergency teams are working in New York City and Washington, D.C. to help with local rescue efforts. Our first priority is to get help to those who have been injured and to take every precaution. Protect our citizens at home and around the world from further attacks. The functions of our government continue without interruption. Federal agencies in Washington, which had to be evacuated today, are reopening.
He knew just what to do. He's got